In early June, the hills were dry and dusty, and forest fires broke out, destroying shrubs and trees, killing birds and small animals. The resin in the pines made these trees burn more fiercely, and the wind would take sparks from the trees. And carry them into the dry grass and leaves, so that new fires would spring up before the old ones had died out. Fortunately, Bina's village was not in the pine belt. The fires did not reach it, but Naughty was surrounded by a fire that raged for 3 days. And the children had to stay away from school. And then, towards the end of June, the monsoon rains arrived and there was an end to forest fires. The monsoon lasts 3 months, and the lower Himalayas would be drenched in rain, mist and cloud for the next 3 months. The first rain arrived while Bina, Prakash and Sonu were returning home from school. Those first few drops on the dusty path made them cry out with excitement. Then the rain grew heavier and a wonderful aroma rose from the earth. "The best smell in the world," exclaimed Bina. Everything suddenly came to life. The grass, the crops, the trees, the birds, even the leaves of the trees glistened and looked new. That first wet weekend, Bina and Sonu helped their mother plant beans, maize and cucumbers. Sometimes when the rain was very heavy, they had to run indoors. Otherwise, they worked in the rain, the soft mud clinging to their bare legs. Prakash now owned a black dog with one ear up and one ear down. The dog ran around getting in everyone's way, barking at cows, goats, hens and humans without frightening any of them. Prakash said it was a very clever dog, but no one else seemed to think so. Prakash also said it would protect the village from the leopard, but others said the dog would be the first to be taken. He'd run straight into the jaws of Mr. Spots. In Naughty, Tanya Ramola was trying to find a dry spot in the quarters she'd been given. It was an old building and the roof was leaking in several places. Mugs and buckets were scattered about the floor in order to catch the drip. Mr. Money had dug up all his potatoes and presented them to the friends and neighbors who had given him lunches and dinners. He was having the time of his life, planting dahlia bulbs all over his garden. "I'll have a field of many colored dahlias," he announced. "Just wait till the end of August." "Watch out for those porcupines," warned his sister. "They eat dahlia bulbs too." Mr. Money made an inspection tour of his moat, no longer in flood, and found everything in good order. Prakash has done his job well. Now when the children crossed the stream, they found that the water level had risen by about a foot. Small cascades had turned into waterfalls. Ferns had sprung up on the banks. Frogs chanted. Prakash and his dog dashed across the stream. Bina and Sonu followed more cautiously. The current was much stronger now and the water was almost up to their knees. Once they had crossed the stream, they hurried along the path, anxious not to be caught in a sudden downpour. By the time they reached school, each of them had two or three leeches clinging to their legs. They had to use salt to remove them. The leeches were the most troublesome part of the rainy season. Even the leopard did not like them. It could not lie in the long grass without getting leeches on its paws and face. One day, when Bina, Prakash and Sonu were about to cross the stream, they heard a low rumble which grew louder every second. Looking up at the opposite hill, they saw several trees shudder, tilt outwards and begin to fall. Earth and rocks bulged out from the mountain, then came crashing down into the ravine. "Landslide," shouted Sonu. "It carried away the path," said Bina. "Don't go any further." There was a tremendous roar as more rocks, trees and bushes fell away and crashed down the hillside. Prakash's dog, who had gone ahead, came running back, tail between his legs. They remained rooted to the spot until the rocks had stopped falling and the dust had settled. Birds circled the area, calling wildly. A frightened barking deer ran past them. "We can't go to school now," said Prakash. "There's no way around." They turned and trudged home through the gathering mist. When Kohli Prakash's parents had heard the roar of the landslide, they were setting out in search of the children. When they saw them, they emerged from the mist, waving cheerfully. They had to miss school for another 3 days, and Bina was afraid they might not be able to take their final exams. Although Prakash was not really troubled at the thought of missing exams, he did not like feeling helpless just because their path had been swept away. So he explored the hillside until he found a goat track. Going around the mountain, it joined up with another path near Naughty. This made them walk longer, by a mile. But Bina did not mind. It was much cooler now that the rains were in full swing. The only trouble with the new route was that it passed close to the leopard's lair. The animal had made this area its own since being forced to leave the dam area. One day Prakash's dog ran ahead of them, barking furiously. Then he ran back whimpering. "He is always running away from something," observed Sonu. But a minute later, he understood the reason for the dog's fear. They rounded a bend and Sonu saw the leopard standing in their way. They were struck dumb, too terrified to run. It was a strong, sinewy creature. A long growl rose from its throat. It seemed ready to spring. They stood perfectly still, afraid to move or say a word. And the leopard must have been equally surprised. It stared at them for a few seconds, then bounded across the path into the oak forest. Sonu was shaking. Bina could hear her heart hammering. Prakash could only stammer. "Did you see the way he sprang? Wasn't he beautiful?" He forgot to look at his watch for the rest of the day. A few days later, Sonu stopped and pointed to a large outcrop of rock on the next hill. The leopard stood far away them, outlined against the sky. It looked strong, majestic. Standing beside it were two young cubs. "Look at those little ones," exclaimed Sonu. "So it's a female, not a male," said Prakash. "That's why she was killing so often," said Bina. "She had to feed her cubs too." They remained still for several minutes, gazing up at the leopard and her cubs. The leopard family took no notice of them. "She knows we are here," said Prakash, "but she doesn't care. She knows we won't harm them." "We are cubs too," said Sonu. "Yes," said Bina, "and there's still plenty of space for all of us. Even when the dam is ready, there will still be room for leopards and humans." The school exams were over, the rains were nearly over too, the landslide had been cleared, and Bina, Prakash and Sonu were once again crossing the stream. There was a chill in the air, for it was the end of September. Prakash had learned to play the flute quite well, and he played on the way to school and then again on the way home. As a result, he did not look at his watch so often. One morning, they found a small crowd in front of Mr. Mani's house. "What could have happened?" wondered Bina. "I hope he hasn't got lost again." "Maybe he is sick," said Sonu. "Maybe it's the porcupine," said Prakash. But it was none of these things. Mr. Mani's first dahlia was in bloom, and half the village had turned out to look at it. It was a huge red double dahlia, so heavy that it had to be supported with sticks. No one had ever seen such a magnificent flower. Mr. Mani was a happy man, and his mood only improved over the coming weeks. As more and more dahlia flowered, crimson, yellow, purple, mauve, white, button dahlias, pom-pom dahlias, potted dahlias, strip dahlias, Mr. Mani had them all. A dahlia even turned up on Tanya Ramola's desk. He got on quite well with her now, and another brightened up the headmaster's study. A week later, on their way home, it was almost the last day of the school term, Bina, Prakash and Sonu talked about what they might do when they grew up. "I think I'll become a teacher," said Bina. "I'll teach children about animals and birds and trees and flowers." "Better than maths," said Prakash. "I'll be a pilot," said Sonu. "I want to fly a plane like Miss Ramola's brother." "And what about you, Prakash?" asked Bina. Prakash just smiled and said, "Maybe I'll be a flute player." And he put the flute to his lips and played a sweet melody. "Well, the world needs flute players too," said Bina, as they fell into step beside him. The leopard had been stalking a barking deer. She paused when she heard the flute and the voices of the children. Her own young ones were growing quickly, but the girl and the two boys did not look much older. They had started singing their favorite song again. 5 more miles to go. We climbed through rain and snow, a river to cross, a mountain to pass. Now we 4 more miles to go. The leopard waited until they had passed before returning to the trail of the barking deer.